What's up, everybody? Nolan of Black Diamond Services. I've got a heck of a job for you guys. Now, normally I would show you why with a UV light because it has got a lot of pet stains, but I don't need to show you where they are because you can see them as clear as day. Every one of these brown spots, every one of them is pet urine spots. Now, I know what you're thinking. Besides possibly gross, is why don't they just rip the carpet out? Well, here is one of the biggest reasons why. This house is, I believe, now bank owned, and the cost to replace it far outweighs what they want to do to get this house sold. So, this area in the hallway is absolutely the worst. So they opted to have it cleaned. So this room is pretty basic. Just needs to be cleaned. Doesn't get a lot of traffic. I think there was like one pet stain or two in here when I originally came by and looked at it. But oh my gosh, guys, I have my work cut out for me. So I already told them I recommended replacement and that this is not going to be a cure-all. And they were understanding of that, but I'm definitely documenting this because this is going to be a doozy of a job, and I can't wait to see what it's going to turn out to look like. So let's jump into it. All right, guys, so she said that they vacuumed already, but you know how I roll. Well, gotta make sure that the power source works. Holy smokes. Well, that one certainly doesn't. All right, let's hope that this one right here. Oh, thank goodness. Empty canister. Let's see what happens. Did they really vacuum? And if they did, what type of vacuum? I already see stuff popping through. Question is, was it vacuumed before it was completely cleared out? These guys, look at that. Keeps up, I might have a full canister before I finish this room. Alright, guys, so it wasn't as bad as I was expecting. This is actually the entire house. It looks like the master bedroom probably just didn't get done because not a ton more came out. But that is still a lot to just take somebody's word for it that it was already vacuumed. so this room is nowhere near as bad as the hallway, living room, master bedroom, and the other spare bedrooms. As you can see, after this CRB, it looks pretty damn good. There's just some buildup up against the walls from those blinds being shut, or the drapes being shut for so long, that the only area for soil to get under is right there. So it kind of traps it there. And after a long period of time, it could become filtration damage. Sometimes you can't always get the damage to the carpet to look better, but that's my goal today on this room. But otherwise, you saw how it was looking, the CRB on the other rooms and just pre-spray. It's already made a pretty good difference, so I'm confident that this is going to turn out well. But like I said earlier on, I did suggest replacement. But it is a bank-owned home. They just want to sell it as is, but get it clean so it's presentable. So, totally understandable. Whoever's going to buy the house is going to pull this carpet out anyways and put what they want. This is pretty old carpet, which so far from what I could tell, it's cleaning up pretty well. Just from vacuuming, pre-spraying, and CRB, if it wasn't hit so hard with pet urine, I'd probably advise to hold on to it. Take a look at what is still stuck under the brushes. So, a lot of junk. Not a ton, because you probably saw there was some kick out. But this is all the stuff that's just stuck in here still, that was remaining in the carpet, even after they allegedly vacuumed and I vacuumed. So why the CRB is extremely important, the proof is right here. That's why it's built into our pricing to do it on pretty much every single job. So we can make sure that we get this out of the carpet before we have to try and extract it with our wand, which takes longer and yields lower results. All right, guys, so on this one, I'm doing two things different. I should say slightly different. Number one is this carpet wand has larger jets on it, meaning higher flow. So my output is gonna be more at a time. So this is set to 12 flow, where my other wand is set to 8. And then the other thing is 2-inch hose all the way back to the filter, and then two separate 2-inch hoses to the machine. So like 4 to the door, which gets commonly called that. So the reason why I'm doing that is because I want to maximize my suction, and because of all the heavy spots, I want to make sure I rinse really well too. So that's gonna help me out in the long run. You know, more output at a time means I don't have to go over it quite as much as well. So this is obviously the room that's not too bad. It's the furthest point in the house, which is I'm glad for, because I want more dwell time on the spots. So that'll just be beneficial. So sometimes it's good that when the room that's not as bad as anything else is the furthest one away, so you can allow that extra dwell time to handle business elsewhere. And then it'll be ready to go when you get to it. little drain. It was to be expected. It was going to be pretty bad. So apparently this is for the alarm system. It's got buttons on both sides and it was underneath these drapes. And I thought it was the cable wire. A lot of times that's exactly what it appears to be. So it was sitting underneath here and my wand just barely touched the button and set the alarm off. Thankfully, the real estate agent has the code and she answered right away. So I was able to turn the alarm off. So that is a first. I have never seen one of those hooked up and left on the floor like that. But of course, that one is for a TV. So that was a first. Ooh, caught me off guard. Thank you. handful of bleach spots. One right here. Another one was in the living room. Otherwise, you can see this carpet is actually cleaning up really well, considering how bad it is, and now was. I'm actually impressed that it's looking as well as it is. About 222 degrees. Final water dump. All right, now let's check out the filter. It's been a while since I've done a filter reveal, how bad it was. So considering this job, I'd be highly surprised if there wasn't a lot in here. Oh yeah, definitely. Not very full, but it's just, oh, actually, more than I thought. Yeah, the bag's probably about 80% full. Ooh.